What was supposed to be on the school board agenda tonight is something dozens of districts across the metro are facing right now. Millions of dollars in budget shortfalls, and balancing it could mean layoffs and program cuts.
But this comes after the legislature passed a record $2 billion in new school funding last year, leading to questions about why districts don't have enough cash. Jennifer Hoff is looking into where that money is going. Jennifer?
Randy, any expert will tell you funding education is complicated. But consider this, that there are two streams, and half of that historic money was for new mandated programs. The other half pays for more routine expenses that now are even more costly.
Scott Kroonquist knows money.
It is a lot of money, yeah.
And education, as the longtime leader of an association advocating for 50 of the metro's largest school districts that in its just released survey found more than half are facing a total $300 million budget shortfall, despite a record $2 billion boost in state aid.
Even though we saw a big increase this last session, you know, we've still been digging out of that hole for the last two decades.
He says half the historic money is for government mandated programs like free school meals, a new reading curriculum, and extended unemployment benefits.
So is it fair to say then some of that historic funding was frankly already earmarked?
Absolutely. And about half of the funding went then for what's called our general fund. That is the funds that's really available for school operations.
That half pays for things like school supplies, transportation, and salaries hit hard by inflation and staffing shortages, as more than 100 districts are still negotiating contracts.
It makes it so that localities have to fill in the gap.
McAllister political science professor Leslie Lavery says the disconnect deepens at the polls, too. If voters think districts are well-funded, less likely then to pass a levy.
The federal and state government are going to need to take action if we care about our public schools, if we want people to go into teaching and continue this public service.
Add in low teacher morale and an aging workforce ready to retire, pushing even more out of the profession that the head of the statewide teachers union said is a longtime crisis growing on the backs of educators.
And I think the fact that there are shortfalls being reported by the school district just goes to show how dire things were. And they're saying, time's up. It's time to recognize us.
And Kroonquist there in the story is now going so far to go back to the legislature and ask for even more funding, supplemental funding, despite it not even being a budget year. He wants $100 million that he hopes to get by the end of the session, which would be about May here this time of year. And this comes, of course, as the state just last week announced that it is forecasting a budget surplus of nearly $4 billion. So certainly some would say, Randy, that there's quite a bit still money out there.
All right, Jennifer, thanks.